Hello students, get ready for today's economics class. Today we will start with the first chapter of economics, that is development. Now first we will start with the meaning of development. What is development? Development is progress. It can be in any sphere of life. It can be social, personal or national development. Let's take one example of national development. National development, we include increase in standard of living of people, increase in per capita income, increase in national income, better infrastructure, increase in literacy rate, and increase in employment. Let's take your example. As a student, if you secured 80% marks in 8th class and 90% marks in 9th class. So you secured better marks in 9th class. That is development or progress. In this chapter, we will study main these critical topics like what we would like to live, what we would like to do, how we would like to live, and how we want our country should look like. So in this chapter, we will discuss all these topics and we are always talking about or thinking about options which can lead to a better life. Now look at this question. What is development? Development is a process that creates growth, progress, positive change, or the addition of physical, economic, environmental, social, and demographic components. Now look at this mind map. In this chapter, we will study main these topics. So the first topic is features of development. Second topic is national development. Third topic is how to compare development of different countries. Here we will discuss all the indicators used to compare development of different countries. Fourth topic is public facilities. In public facilities, we include what are public facilities, who is providing these facilities, and do you think these facilities are equally available to all? Fifth topic is how to check health status. So there is one method to check whether the person is nourished or undernourished. Last topic is sustainable development. This is a very important current topic to have a good life. So here we will discuss what is sustainable development and how we can achieve sustainable development. Let's come to the next page. So look at this question. What are aspirations? So aspiration is a desire. It is a hope, dream, or a goal. Everybody is having aspirations in life. It can be social, career, and personal aspirations. Like you want to become a doctor or an engineer, or you want to get a big car, or you want promotion in job. Everything is aspiration or a dream or a goal. Now all the individuals are having different goals. Look at this table. So here has been given different categories of persons with different developmental goals. So first category is landless rural laborer. The landless people who are working on other people's land. So what can be their developmental goal? To get proper days of work and to get better wages. Now next is prosperous farmer from Punjab or a rich farmer from Punjab. What can be their developmental goal? Their developmental goal can be to sell the crops at high prices, to send their children to abroad to get higher education. Now the third category of person is farmers who depend only on rain for growing crops. So as we know, crop growing is dependent on water, but rain is very uncertain. So sometime it is more than requirement, sometime it is less than requirement. So their developmental goal can be to get proper irrigation facilities. Next is a rural woman from land owning family. What can be her developmental goal? To get freedom, to send the children to abroad, to get proper education. Now next is urban unemployed youth. As we know, in urban area, youth is unemployed. Many people are educated, but they are unable to get jobs. So what can be their developmental goal? To get secured job. Next is a boy from a rich urban family. His developmental goal can be to expand his business, to have a luxurious life. A girl from a rich urban family, what can be her developmental goal? To get freedom, to go to abroad to get higher education. Last is an Adivasi from Narmada Valley. An Adivasi from Narmada Valley, as we know, when any dam is built on any valley, the people are displaced from that area who are living in that area. So what can be their developmental goal? As they lost their livelihood, so their developmental goal can be to get rehabilitation facility and to get secured life, proper sources of livelihood, so they can fulfill their basic needs. Now look at this town site topic, highlighted area. There is one question: do all of these persons have same notions of development or progress? Answer is no, absolutely no, because they have different situations or circumstances, so they have different notions of development or progress. Like a poor farmer or a rich farmer, they are facing different circumstances, so their developmental goal cannot be same. Farmer from Punjab and Rajasthan are living in separate areas, facing separate atmospheric conditions, so their developmental goal will be different. So they have different notions of development or progress. It depends upon their own life circumstances. Now come to the next page. So here on the top is given one word, conflicting. What is conflicting? Conflicting means anything which is harmful for one but beneficial for the other. Look at this question. Here is given one question. Different persons can have different developmental goals, and what may be development for one may not be development for the other. It may even be destructive for the other. So this is question that is related with the conflicting developmental goals, means any goal that is beneficial for him but it can be harmful or destructive for the other. So here has been given two examples. Like one example is given of one girl expects as much freedom and opportunity as her brother, and this we see in most of the houses, that boys are getting more freedom and opportunities as compared to girls. Now we take the another example, that is of dams. While making dams, many of the people are displaced from that areas. So dams are beneficial for the industrialist who are getting electricity supply, but this is harmful for the people who are displaced from that area. Now let's take one another example of a factory owner. Like if in any factory workers are working, owner is paying them less wages. So this is beneficial for the owner but harmful for the workers. So these are the some examples of conflicting developmental goals. Anything that is beneficial for one but harmful for the other. Now I'll come to a next topic, that is income and other goals. As we know, income is the main objective in everybody's life. Everybody is working hard to get good income or to earn good so that they can have a better life, they can fulfill their needs properly, But do you think income is the only objective in anybody's life? Answer is no. If you are having very big house, but you are not getting respect, you are not getting freedom. Do you want that big house? No. So income is the not only objective in our life. There are some other factors in our life that are equally important to us than income. So like that is respect of others, dignity, security, freedom, and equal treatment. So along with income, these factors are equally important in our life. So here has been given one word, material things. So what is the material and non-materialistic things? So look at this question now. What are materialistic and non-materialistic things? Materialistic goods are those goods which we can buy with money. For example, car, house or anything. And non-materialistic goods are those which we cannot buy with money. For example, freedom, respect. So our quality of life depends both on materialistic and non-materialistic things. To have a good life, we cannot ignore any of these factors. Thank you.